हाय स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 8 पार्ट 3 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। आई होप यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर एक्सरसाइज 1.1 एंड स्टडीड ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट रैशनल नंबर्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन। लेसन 1, रैशनल नंबर्स। Representation of rational numbers on the number line, page number 15. You can open your textbook and page number 15. You have learned to represent natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and rational numbers on the number line. Let us revise them. How to represent natural numbers on the number line? You all knows natural numbers means counting numbers. It start from 1, 2, 3, etc. So first you have to mark a line and mark equal distance and start from 1, 2, 3, etc. And the line extends indefinitely onto the right side of 1. So from the 1, there is no number less than 1. Left side of 1. Only the number extend indefinitely to the right side of 1. The next topic, how to represent whole numbers on the number line. What is the meaning of whole numbers? Whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So again, draw a line, mark equal distance, and you have to start from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Is it clear? The next one, the line extends indefinitely to the right, but it starts from 0 and there are no numbers to the left of 0. The next one, how to represent integers on the number line. What is the meaning of integer? The collection of negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers are called integers. Again, draw a number line. You have to make equal distance first, then mark 0. And right of 0, that is 1, 2, 3, etc. And left of 0 is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Next one, the line extends indefinitely on both the sides, right? You can see that this is 0 and both the sides, the line is extends indefinitely. Representation of rational numbers. Any rational numbers can be represented on the number line. In a rational number, the denominator tells the number of equal parts into which the first unit has been divided, and the numerator tells how many of these parts are considered. For example, 4 by 9. So what is the denominator here? 9. So it means that 4 by 9 means 4 of 9 equal parts on the right of 0. So here denominator is 9. So it means that the number of equal parts into which the first unit has been divided. Suppose their denominator is 9, you have to take 9 divisions here. So first you have to draw a line, then mark 0, and first one after 0, first one is 1 by, here denominator is 9, so write here 1 by 9. The next number 2 by 9, 3 by 9, 4 by 9, 5 by 9, 6 by 9, like this you have to mark 7 by 9, 8 by 9, now 9 by 9. The meaning of 9 by 9, 9 divided by 9, that is 1. So up to there you have to mark, then we have to represent 4 by 9. And this is positive number, it comes right side of 0. And where is 4 by 9? Just put a circle here. Circle. Is it clear? Yes. Next example 2, minus 7 by 4. Here you can see this. It's a negative integer. So you have to mark left of 0. So minus 7 by 4 means 7 of 4 equal parts on the left of 0. Clear? Now draw a number line. First you have to mark 0 and the number comes left of 0. So it becomes minus 1 by 4, minus 2 by 4, minus 3 by 4, minus 4 by 4. Again, minus 4 by 4 means minus 1. Again, minus 5 by 4, minus 6 by 4, minus 7 by 4 and minus 8 by 4. What is the meaning of minus 8 by 4? 8 by 4. 4 2s are 8, so that is minus 2. Now we have to mark minus 7 by 4. So just circle minus 7 by 4. Clear? Now try this, page number 17. Just open your textbook, page number 17. Try this, write in your max notebook. First one, write the rational number for each point labeled, write it with a letter. Clear? First one, there is a number line and it's marked 0 by 5. So denominator is 5. That means 5 equal divisions, right? So 0 by 5. So next number is 1 by 5. So what is A? A is equal to 1 by 5. Now 2 by 5, 3 by 5. So what is the next number? That is 4 by 5. So B is equal to 4 by 5 and C is equal to 5 by 5. What is the meaning of 5 by 5? It is equal to 1. And 6 by 5 is given 7 by 5. So what is the next number? That is 8 by 5 and 9 by 5. So D is equal to 8 by 5 and E is equal to 9 by 5. So just write this question in a max notebook and draw this number line and you have to write the answer. And question number 2, you can do it as homework. Next, we are going to study how to represent minus 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 on the number line. Again, it's a rational number. Suppose you have to draw a number line, then take equal distance, then right of 0 is positive number and left of 0 is negative number. This much you have to understand. So, first take equal distance. Now, this is 0 and the right of 0, that is positive number, that is 1 by 2. So, here denominator is 2, so mark it as 1 by 2. Now 2 by 2, that is 1. Now 3 by 2. Next one is 4 by 2. What is the meaning of 4 by 2? That is 2. Clear? Now here left of 0, that is minus 1 by 2. Minus 2 by 2. 2 by 2 meaning is minus 1. So minus 1 by 2 is here and 1 by 2 is here. So you can underline there or you can just circle it here. 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. Right? And we want minus 1 by 2. So just put a circle on O. The next one, represent minus 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 on the number line. Again, draw a number line and take equal distance. Then 0 and left right of 0, 1 by 4. Here denominator is 4, so it will come 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, then 4 by 4. 4 by 4 meaning is 1 and left of 0 is minus 1 by 4, minus 2 by 4, minus 3 by 4 and minus 4 by 4, that is minus 1. And we have to represent minus 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. So just take a pen and just put a circle here and here also. Next one is rational numbers between two rational numbers. So how many rational numbers between two rational numbers? Between any two given rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers. Suppose, for example, 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1, how many numbers are there? 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, or 0.11, 0.12, 0.111, 0.111, 121, something. Like, there are infinite numbers are there. So, between any two given rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers. Exercise 1.2. Question number 1. Represent these numbers on the number line. So, first one is 7 by 4. So, here denominator is 4. So, you have to take 4 equal divisions. Right? So, again, draw a number line. Then take equal distance. So, mark first 0. And this is positive number. So, it comes right of 0. So, that is 1 by 4. 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 4 by 4. 4 by 4 meaning is 1. Then 5 by 4, 6 by 4, 7 by 4. We want 7 by 4. Just put a circle here. Now question number 2, you can do it as homework. This is minus 5 by 6. It is a negative number, so it comes left of 0. Now question number 2, represent minus 2 by 11, minus 5 by 11, minus 9 by 11 on the number line. So draw a number line. Mark 0 and these are negative numbers, so it comes left of 0. So mark here denominator is 11. So that is minus 1 by 11, minus 2 by 11, minus 3 by 11, minus 4 by 11, minus 5 by 11, minus 6 by 11, minus 7 by 11, and minus 8 by 11, minus 9 by 11, minus 10 by 11, minus 11 by 11. So that means minus 1 and again more numbers and then minus 2. So we want only these numbers, so just circle here, that is minus 2 by 11. And we want minus 5 by 11 and minus 9 by 11. Question number 3. Write 5 rational numbers which are smaller than 2. So, if you draw the number line, it's very clear for you. So, whenever you are solving, first you just draw a number line. Then you have to find the numbers smaller than 2. You can see in the number line, less than, smaller than 2. There are infinite numbers are there. So, question is any 5 rational numbers. You can write any 5. You can choose any numbers smaller than 2. Any rational numbers smaller than 2. So I have written 5 rational numbers here. It's not compulsory that you write the same. You can write, you can choose any rational numbers less than 2 or smaller than 2. The 5 rational numbers smaller than 2 are here. 1, 1 by 2, 0, minus 1 by 2, minus 1. So, 5 rational numbers smaller than 2 are 1, 1 by 2, 0, minus 1 by 2 and minus 1. Question number 4. Find 10 rational numbers between minus 2 by 5 and 1 by 2. So, whenever they are asking you to find rational numbers, first you have to convert the rational number with the same denominators. So, here denominators are different. So, first convert with the same denominator. So, we first convert minus 2 by 5 and 1 by 2 to rational numbers with the same denominators. So, first take the first fraction, that is minus 2 by 5, and multiply by 4. But it is not compulsory to multiply by 4. You can take any number and multiply here. But only one condition is the denominator should be same. So, I multiply here 4. So, multiply the same number in the numerator. So, minus 2 multiply by 4. So, minus 2 multiplied by 4, that is minus 8, 5 4s are 20, and 1 by 2, so 1 by 2, so here 20, so 2 into which number 20, that is 2 tens are, multiply 10 in the numerator, that is 1 tens are, so 1 tens are 10 and 2 tens are 20. So, 10 rational numbers between minus 2 by 5 and 1 by 2 are between minus 8 by 20 and 10 by 20. There are infinite rational numbers, you can choose any rational number and write. It's not compulsory, you have to write the same as I have written here. So, between minus 8 by 20 and 10 by 20, I have written minus 27 by 20, 6, minus 6 by 20, minus 5 by 20, minus 4 by 20, minus 3 by 20, minus 2 by 20, minus 1 by 20, 0, 1 by 20 and 2 by 20. And question number 2, this is extra sum. So, write in your notebook as extra sum and solve yourself. Find 10 rational numbers between 2 by 3 and 4 by 5. Whenever the question comes, first you have to check the rational number with the same denominators. So, here different denominators. So, first you have to convert to rational numbers with the same denominators. So, after converting, you can find out any 10 rational numbers. Is it clear? Question number 5. Find 5 rational numbers between 2 by 3 and 4 by 5. So, find 5 rational numbers. So, you can write any 5 because there are infinite rational numbers are there. You have to find out only 5. So, you can choose any 5 rational numbers between these two. So first, here denominator is 3 and here is 5. They are not same. So, first you have to convert these rational number with the same denominators. So, first convert 2 by 3 and 4 by 5 to rational numbers with the same denominators. So, 2 by 3. Again, I am saying that it's not compulsory. You have to multiply 15 here. You can take any numbers, but only one condition is the denominator should be same. So, 2 by 3. So, write 2 by 3. I multiply here 15. So, 3 15s are. When you multiply 15 here, you have to multiply the same number in the numerator. So, 2 multiply by 15. 15 2s are 30 and 15 3s are 45. And 4 by 5. Here we got denominator 45, so here also you should get denominator 45. So 5 into which number 45, that is 5 9s are. So multiply 9 in the numerator, that is 4 9s are. 4 9s are 36 and 5 9s are 45. Now what are the 5 rational numbers between 2 by 3 and 4 by 5? They are between 30 and 36, that is 31 by 45, 32 by 45, 33 by 45. 34 by 45 and 35 by 45. Question number 2, minus 3 by 2 and 5 by 3. Again, 2 and 3 denominators are not same. So, students, first you have to convert this rational number with the same denominator. So, minus 2, 3 by 2 and 5 by 2, 5 by 3, two rational numbers with the same denominators. So, minus 3 by 2, so multiply any number here. So, 2 3s are 6 and minus 3 multiply by 3. 3 3s are 9, minus 9, so minus 9. And 2 3s are 6 and 5 by 3. So, 3 2s are, so here denominator is 6. So, 3 into which number 6? So, 3 2s are 6, multiply 2 in the numerator. That is 5 2s are. So, 5 2s are 10, 3 2s are 6. Now, we got minus 9 by 6 and 10 by 6. We want to find any 5 rational numbers between minus 9 by 6 and 10 by 6. Again, I am saying that you can choose any rational numbers between minus 9 by 6 and 10 by 6. It is not compulsory to write the same rational numbers. So, minus 9 by 6 and 10 by 6 between these two numbers, you can write minus 8 by 6, minus 7 by 6, minus 6 by 6, minus 5 by 6 and minus 4 by 6. The third one, you can do it as homework, that is 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. And one more extra sum I am giving here, that is fourth one, find 5 rational numbers between minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 2. Question number 6. Write 5 rational numbers greater than minus 2. So whenever question is asked for you to find the greater number of the given number, you have to find the right side of the given number. So if you draw number line, it's more clear for you. So when you are solving, you just draw one rough number line and mark 0, minus 1, minus 2 and 1, 2. Then you can find out the numbers greater than minus 2. The 5 rational numbers greater than minus 2 are, what are the numbers right of minus 2? That is minus 1, 0, minus 1 by 2, 1 and 1 by 2. There are infinite numbers are there. You can find, choose any numbers greater than minus 2. Homework, question number 7. Find 10 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 3 by 4. Problems from workbook. So, what the chapter is completed here. Now, we are discussing the workbook sums. So, what are the sums I am going to give? That already explained. So, you can do all the sums yourself. Any doubt, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Page number 5. Fill in the blanks. So, these are the topic we have already discussed. So, you can recall and you can complete yourself all the fill-ups yourself. The question number 5, state appropriate properties of the rational numbers. So, all the properties already we have explained in the class. So, just again recall the properties. And learn once again all the properties, then you have to write what are the properties in one by one here in the workbook itself. It's number 8, 9 and 10. Write the additive inverse, write the reciprocal and this is representation. So, these two already explained last class and this topic I explained today. So, this is mixed fraction. You can convert to improper 4 ones are 4, 4 plus 3, that is 7 by 4. Then you can represent on the number line. So, all these sums, do it in your workbook. And question number 11, again, represent. Question number 12, find 10 rational numbers. And this again, today in the class we have explained. And question number 13, simplify the following using appropriate properties. So, last class we have explained how to solve this simplification. So, that also you can do it here. Question number 4, 5, 6. Continuation of simplification. You can do it yourself. If any doubt, you can ask me in the group. And whenever you are solving workbook sums, please use your pencil. So, if you are not getting correct answer, you can erase and do it again. this chapter is completed here. So all the exercises, that is exercise 1.1 and 1.2, that to complete in a max notebook. And after watching the video, you have to say the attendance 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Any doubt, you can ask me in the WhatsApp group. And all the sums, extra sums, you have to solve in the maths notebook. And the sums from your workbook, you have to solve in the workbook itself using your pencil. Thank you.